Asian markets traded mixed on Wednesday, taking a pause from the recent rally amid a lack of regional developments. Trading edges Ron Acoba says emerging markets like the Philippines continue to lag behind Wall Street, despite still reporting lower COVID case counts, because the region is still falling behind vaccination and is less equipped with treatment facilities, as well as fiscal and monetary support should the Omicron variant explode and trigger another lockdown. Acoba sees the local bourse trading sideways in the near term before retesting record highs next year.
If you look at the bigger picture, the index is actually facing a resistance at its 2021 high of 7.4, and more importantly, facing a resistance at its previous at the neckline of a previous multi-year top, which it took about 7 years to complete. So given the duration, this actually leads to a concentration of overhang or concentration of supply around the 7.4, 7.5. So it actually requires a bit of time for the market to mop up all of this supply. And that is why I said, and I expect that the index will continue to consolidate. We're en route to that the index will finally clear the 7.5 level. It's actually very easy for us to revisit, take note of this, our previous high of 9,000. And I think that we'll probably hit that perhaps in the middle of next year.
For the day, the PSE index gained nearly 0.75% to close at 73.34, though on holiday thin trade. Investors go on break again on Thursday for Rizal Day before the half-day trade on New Year's Eve. In corporate stories, fiber broadband provider Converge ICT has added 1.3 terabits per second capacity in the C2C cable system, Asia's largest privately owned submarine cable network, making its submarine cable fully redundant, meaning continued availability even if there's a submarine cable outage. The C2C cable system stretches 17,000 kilometers, connecting the Philippines to major data hubs like Hong Kong, Taiwan, Singapore, Japan, Korea, and China. For context, 1 terabits per second is 1 gigabyte of data passing through the network per second. So far, half of the additional capacity is already active. Meanwhile, McDonald's Philippines, which is jointly owned by tycoons George Yang and Andrew Tan, is bullish it can achieve full recovery by 2022. Managing Director Margot Torres shares they're now working to future-proof their business model.
You really need to future-proof the business and make sure you have other channels like delivery, and we're also, half of our stores are drive-through. So if there is a new variant like Omicron or maybe in the future, I think it should already be incorporated in the plans and even the business model. So when dine-in is removed, because that's the first thing that's going to go when cases surge and alert levels rise, then you'd rely now on your other channels.
How much of your sales now are coming from the online channels?
Online, okay. Mm-hmm. There was a shift. It used to be pre-pandemic, like about 70% was dine-in. That shifted now. We now have about 60 to 70% combined drive-through and delivery. So we actually opened 36.
Wow.
We are actually poised for growth in the next 5 years, and we will continue to expand.
McDonald's opened 36 new stores this year, exceeding its target of 30, bringing store network to 691. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.